Okay, here we go, NAMM 2017, first video. Mick here with Andertons TV, and I'm very pleased to say we're on the Gretsch booth, and I'm with Adam Bonesmith, who is product manager for Europe.
For Europe and beyond, yes.
Okay, so more than that. Yeah. So what can we expect for 2017?
Well, the big thing about with Gretsch 2017 is continuing what we started last year. So last year we upgraded all the hollow body models that we have. The hollow bodies obviously is our bread and butter, if you like, so they were done. This year we're doing center blocks and solid body models, so upgrading those in line with what we did with the hollow bodies last year. So we're starting in the corner here. These are the center block models. So this is a professional collection. Probably 3 years ago now, we first introduced our center block line, where we had the Panther models, just two models, black and white, real simple. They were really successful, but it came time to change the format and take it a bit beyond what we've done before.
Sure.
So we've expanded the line to what we now call the Broadcaster, with a K, which we can do because that was our name originally.
For anyone who doesn't know, there was a legal fight between Fender and Gretsch back in 1950.
Yeah. When Fender called their new guitar a Broadcaster, and we had a drum kit called a Broadcaster and some banjos called Broadcaster with a K. I think we won that one.
Yeah, of course, now one big happy family between Gretsch and Fender, and Broadcaster returns with a K.
Yes,
nice.
Indeed. Yeah, so a whole range of them. And they're center block guitars. The way they differ from the old Panthers is several ways. Firstly, they're part of the Player's Edition. So the hollow body Player's Edition last year had all the treble bleed, the no-load tone control, the pin-through Bigsby, the Tusk XL nut, locking tuners, all that stuff. These have got all of that stuff. So they're part of the Player's Edition thing. In addition to that, being center blocks, they have a block down the middle. It's a spruce, solid spruce block, but it has chambering in it to make it a bit lightweight and a bit more resonant. But differing to the Panthers, these are now studded bridges instead of floating bridges.
Right, okay.
So that adjusts the neck angle slightly, allows you to dig in more, play a bit more hard playing, and sort of more what these guitars are probably accustomed to doing.
Yeah, more like what you would expect from a center block guitar.
Exactly.
Is it me, or do they look more traditional than the first lot of center blocks?
We have put things like age binding on them.
Yeah, okay.
We've approached things like the figured woods.
Yeah.
So there are those traditional elements. We have the old style, these just the single arrow knobs, which are from the very early mid-50s for Gretsch. But there's other things about them which are very modern, like the center block, the studded bridge, and the string through Bigsby and all those things.
Great. So new center block. Are they all called Player's Edition Center Block?
The Broadcasters are part of the Player's Edition. One thing I should say, they've got brand new pickups on them. These Filtertrons are the first USA-made Filtertrons that Gretsch produced.
Oh, wow.
Since the 50s or 60s or whatever. So these are USA-made Filtertrons. We're calling them the Fultrons because they are tonally voiced slightly differently to a classic Filtertron. So if you imagine like a traditional PAF humbucker here, classic Gretsch Filtertron here, they're kind of right in the middle.
Okay.
They've got more, it says on the sheet here, they've got more power and they've got more fidelity. Because they're a narrow coil, they have that very kind of clarity, they have clarity to them, which is great for clean sounds, but they have the more power, a bit more of a top end, mid-range punch for distortion and overdrive, which of course a center block is perfect for anyway.
Excellent. Can't wait to get me and Danish Pete rocking with those in the demo room.
Yeah.
Okay, great. So, onwards. You might notice over my shoulder here with a grey ponytail, that's Fred Gretsch. And over there, talking to Jamie Dixon from Guitarist Magazine, is none other than Dwayne Eddy. How cool is that? Acoustics,
yeah. We have, some might say finally, we have expanded the Roots collection of Gretsch instruments to include more acoustic guitars. So Roots has traditionally been very accessible but very cool folk instruments. We have the banjos, mandolins, resonators so forth behind us. Very cool, very successful range of guitars, very affordable price points. We've had probably the best-selling thing with the word Gretsch on it ever was this Jim Dandy guitar.
Yeah.
Probably everyone out there's got one. If they haven't, they should. Very cool guitar, but you know, it's a fun guitar. We've now moved into the serious realm, as it were, with these guitars. Three models, Style 1, Style 2, Style 3. Again, very affordable. You will be amazed when I tell you how much these guitars cost. They're all around the £400 market retail price.
Wow.
Okay. This Style 1, solid spruce top, laminate mahogany back and sides, all gloss finish. Each one of these guitars has a specially designed bracing system, which is specifically for the voice of that particular guitar. So right. It's not the same bracing for each one. It's all quarter sawn spruce. They're so lightweight.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's obviously. What are you calling that? A parlor or?
Yeah, they're kind of like a parlor instrument. They're all slightly different sizes and shapes, but they're all that sort of parlor, the small thing. They all have different body depths to accentuate the particular tone. For example, on the Style 2, you can see quite narrow goes to quite fat. Absolutely designed for the tone it's supposed to be
it's
making.
Almost, I almost want to put that across my lap. And
yeah, I imagine you could do that. They're all to 12 fret join, which is kind of evocative of the era, but also makes the bridge that little bit further back, makes them much more resonant.
Sure.
These things are loud, and they sustain, and they sound nice and rounded. The top end isn't shrill, the bottom end is full and fat. For the size of the guitars and for the price of the guitars, these are incredible. As you felt, so lightweight, they're so resonant. This one, obviously, Style 2 slot head, which is super cool.
Yeah, yeah.
They've all got this Gretsch Scripty logo on there. This one's got this sort of herringbone inlay on there. And then finally, there's a really nice touch on the Style 3, which is kind of the top-end model at the moment. Add a pickguard, add a bit more marquetry on there. Got the sort of B&D style inlays. Yeah. And a lovely tortoiseshell overlay on the headstock, which is kind of really vibey. You know, we've done like the perloid on the resonators before. We thought we'd do that on that, and I think it looks super cool. Rosewood fingerboards, binding on the neck and head, just really cool guitars. And for the money, kind of a no-brainer, you know what I mean?
Yeah, well, as you say, they've been very successful so far. Are they 1 3/4 nuts?
Yes, they are, I believe, yeah.
Ideal
for finger pickers.
It may be interesting or not interesting, but on a lot of entry-level acoustic guitars, or certainly entry-level price up to mid-price, you tend not to get a 1 3/4-inch nut, which is,
yeah.
I personally annoys me because I like a little bit of a wider nut, but that's...
The guitars really lend themselves to that kind of turn of the century, old time, kind of early blues country music, which is that finger pick, that Mississippi John Hurt, that kind of, you know, real finger picking stuff. Not to say they're limited to that, of course, but that is the vibe. The whole roots thing really goes for that early 20th century thing. And with the 12 fret and the slotted headstocks and the marquetry and all that, they're just so vibey, so cool. And I haven't seen anything else like this for the money around. There's other people are offering things like this for twice the price.
Yeah.
But these, when you can have a play of them, you'll see what I mean. They just project like you wouldn't expect.
Wonderful. We missed the opportunity for a nut gag there, but we'll
never wasted that.
Pete and I will be playing them on Acoustic Parody so soon. So yeah, great. Okay, here we are, Vintage Select Series. Now I have a question, Adam.
Yes.
When Pete and I were doing a video for Guitar Parody, so I think it was, we got a little bit confused about Vintage Select, and could you just explain it a little bit about where Vintage Select sits?
Sure. Well, the whole point of this was previously to the beginning of last year, the range of Gretsch products was kind of, you couldn't really tell necessarily if something was a reissue guitar or something was a modern guitar or something was a mixture of both. It kind of just was a little bit messy, and we decided to really make the line much more linear. So basically, the Player's Edition are modern guitars for modern players. Every song, every night is a tagline. It's kind of, it's supposed to be the guitar you can play for every song. For every night, every gig you do, you don't have to change. It's got locking tuners, all those modern appointments. The Vintage Select is for the guys who are more, they want to collect stuff, or they want an authentic guitar to the era. Where with the Vintage Select, we really pick guitars from landmark years in Gretsch's history, I guess, and then pick the specs out of that. And even within those years, as you know, Gretsch has a bit of a history of being quite a lot of changes within a year. So we pick some of our favourite specs, essentially. And there have been a few guitars in the past which have been, you know, a 55 or whatever, but this time we're really making it much clearer. That said, Vintage Select is vintage where vintage makes sense.
Sure.
So, for example, all these guitars have pinned bridges. They wouldn't have had that originally, but it just makes sense to do it because you can't see it. It doesn't detract from the vintage look, but it makes it a much better playing guitar. Stays in tune, doesn't move when you start locking out and all that stuff. They also have treble bleeds on the volume, which make it just, you know, just a more practical use. And it, again, doesn't detract from the vintage look. Other than that, we're pretty close to the spec. And what we've done, as I said earlier on, last year we upgraded all our hollow bodies with the Vintage Select stuff and the Players Edition. This year we're doing the solid bodies. So here at NAMM, Winter NAMM that we're in now, it's the turn of the solid bodies to have their Vintage Select. Later on we'll be doing the Players Edition. So what we have is six models. We picked out the years 53, 58, 57, 59, 59 and 62. All fairly seminal years, but also with fairly distinctive spec like setups on them.
Yep.
The most exciting for me is the 53. We've never done a production model of the 53 before.
Wow.
And this is basically, the Eurojet was introduced in 1954, but the first models were produced in 53, so this is to kind of represent those very first batch of models. So you have details like there's a missing inlay in the first fret, it's got the Scripty logo on the headstock, it's got the slightly lighter stain of the walnut headstock, it's got the aluminium bridge, or aluminum to our local people here, it's got the Bigsby without the black painted trough, it's got the plain top knobs on there, and the white pickguard, just a single ply white pickguard, hardly any shape on like the later ones do, and no logo. These are TV Jones T Armands in here. We've got aged binding, mahogany back and sides, nice stain on there. The classic Gretsch thumbnail strap locks. Just a super cool guitar. I've got this one. This has got my name on it, this one, so I'm gonna put it down so I don't damage my own guitar.
It reminds me of the whole George Harrison vibe.
Yeah, very much. So George Harrison had a 57 model, but it was the same with the Dynasonic pickups and so forth. And because they remain from 53 till 57, they had Dynasonics. And obviously, it's very evocative of George's model. Then the next one, this is talking of 57s, we are doing a 57. But we've chosen, because we have the George models, the signature model is a separate thing. We've chosen to do this, well, we did it before in the Cadillac green, but this one's a metallic, we've changed it to a metallic Cadillac green. We've added the armrest. We've got the authentic 57 style arm on there, and again the other features that the other ones have. They've all got bone nuts now. Previously, some of them had fake bone. The correct Bigsby and so forth. And then it's 53, 57, 58. The White Penguin. So our previous White Penguin had the Dynasonics. It was loosely based on a 55 model, but it wasn't really assigned a year. This is assigned the year of 58. Has all the features that go with it, the tone switch, the armrest, TV Jones classics on there. It's got the pinned space control bridge, period correct Bigsby. We went for the vertical logo.
Sorry, I'm smiling like a loony because I'm just looking at that headstock, just going, yes.
In 58, they actually introduced the horizontal logo. But there were a few produced in 58 that had the vertical logo, and we prefer it. And it makes it kind of a transitional model in a way. So this is the first Penguin we've produced with Filtertrons for quite a long time, except for limited editions. Then the 59s, the 259s, kind of the classic Eurojet when most people think of the Eurojet, and the matching silver jet.
Yeah.
They're basically the same spec except for the colour. Again, TV Jones classics, pinned space control bridge, period correct Bigsby. This one's got a white back painted pickguard. It previously had silver, but most of them in the day had white.
Okay.
But silver on the silver jet.
That is so cool. That is so cool.
Oh, I should mention all of these have the proper 2-inch depth body with the extra wide chambering inside. So they're all semi-hollow.
How wide were they before that? Funnily enough, I was looking at this thinking that looks wider than...
Yeah, they were normally, 1 7/8, which doesn't sound like much, but it does make the difference.
Yeah, it looks...
But the chambering as well is much broader. And that's probably a big thing to mention with Gretsch solid bodies, is they're not solid.
Yeah.
They're chambered. They're moving air inside. That's what the Gretsch sound is. It's never going to sound like another solid body. It's got its own thing going on, and it fits perfectly in the mix when other people in the band, for example, have got other solid body guitars. Hence, for example, a famous duo with the surname of Young.
Yes.
That perfect combination, right? Talking of which, right? So this is a 62 Firebird. So we previously did a 62 type model. We did call that one a 62, but this one we kind of updated it. We just changed it. Obviously, we changed it to red. This is actually a vintage red, so it's slightly darker than the sort of vibrant Firebird red. Gold plating, obviously, just because why not?
I'd just like to say, Mr. Dwayne Eddy just tripped over our lead there.
Yeah, I was just going to borrow a guitar. I don't know why I thought you were filming it.
No, he's filming. It's good. It's nice to meet you, sir.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah.
black back and sides, just how they were, except with a walnut head facing, because that's how they were in the day. Really cool guitar, and like we were alluding to earlier, this is basically what Malcolm Young's guitar looked like before he knackered it up, before he stripped the paint off. Yeah, he stripped the paint off, he put another humbucker in the middle, then he took both of these out, and all sorts of things happened. He's had a Bernstar vibrato on. We've gone with the Gretsch one on this one, just because we can.
Adam alluded to this earlier, but if you play in a two-guitar band, and let's say one of you's playing a Les Paul or a different kind of guitar, and you're looking for a different sound, it sits so brilliantly well, doesn't it?
Basically, if you've got the aforementioned model that you've said over here, and you've got the Fender Stratocaster over here, these sit right bang in the middle.
Yeah.
And in terms of a mix in a two-guitar band or whatever, whether recording or on stage, they just cut right through. They're so good for that, and especially with the various styles of pickups we're creating now, there's something for everyone wherever you want to sit in the mix. Just great sound and really underrated. Shouldn't be written off as a rockabilly guitar, as a lot of people do. And Malcolm Young is a perfect example of that, but so many others, Billy Duffy, the list goes on. That's a vintage select.
Splendid. Right, onwards. Okay, two more things to cover off, Electromatic and Streamliner. Now, I'm a big fan of Electromatic guitars, as you know.
Yeah.
I have the white 5422 TG.
Fine guitar.
Which is that one there, I believe.
That's right.
It is. So, what's happening with Electromatic for 2017?
Well, as I was saying earlier, what we did last year is upgrade all the hollow bodies, one of which is the one you just talked about. This year we're doing center block, so we've upgraded the Electromatic center block range. Basically, kind of changed the aesthetic a little bit and just made it kind of a little bit cooler, I think, basically. The previous version of the double cutaway had three pickups and loads of switches and stuff, and it had cat-sized sound holes, so we've changed it to be more traditional aesthetic, I guess. Still got the same pickups, though. These are the Super Hylotron pickups, which are loosely based sonically on the Hylotron pickups, but those are single coils and these are humbuckers.
Okay.
What it basically means, as the name suggests, high-low. They're quite scooped sound, quite good for overdrive and so forth, but with a bit higher output and with no mains hum, or 60 cycle hum. These ones did have studded bridge before, so these continuing with the studded bridge and the B70 with the tension bar there. We've introduced a treble lead there, we've done the H binding, the traditional style F holes. Probably the biggest thing, as with the hollow bodies, is that we've made the smaller headstock with the binding and got rid of the word Electromatic here.
Yeah.
So it's more a traditional Gretsch look. We moved the word Electromatic down to the pick guard in a sort of much more classy and Gretschy way.
And slightly smaller type.
Yes, slightly. Slightly smaller. And just very cool. And we're basically offering this model in four colours, which are behind me here. We've got the Georgia green. In this lighting, it looks a bit turquoisey, but it is a green, metallic. I've got the vintage orange, classic Gretsch orange. And black, because you can't go wrong with black, right?
Very cool.
And this is a walnut stone.
So, any idea on UK rough prices for those?
Rough prices for these around the £700 mark.
So, kind of in line with what they are now.
Yeah, I think they're a touch cheaper even.
Yeah.
And available now. They should be in your dealers or nowish. So.
Awesome. And so, if you can't stretch to a professional series guitar, a player's edition, or indeed an Electromatic, it's all about Streamliner.
Yes, which are right here. So,
how about that for a link? I should do this for a job, don't you think?
So last year was kind of huge for Gretsch because we introduced the Streamliner at the beginning of last year. The first time we've introduced a range of hollow and semi-hollow guitars at that price point. We'd never had that before. So these ones we introduced last year. Basically a full-size hollow body, single cutaway, and then a full-size thin line, a double cutaway center block, and a junior model. And what we've done this year basically is still got the same guitars, but a new range of colors, some really cool colors. This is my favorite. We had the Brooklyn Burst last year on the single cutaway hollow body, but we've introduced it onto the center block now with the Bixby. So Gretschy. Just to remind everyone out there that these pickups were designed especially for the Streamliner model, designed by Tim Shaw. He knows what he's doing, right?
Yeah.
And again, they're designed to have that kind of Gretsch sound, but to be leaning slightly towards the more traditional humbucker sound as well. Really
Tim,
cool.
Tim Shaw, for anyone who doesn't know, is somebody who helped redesign a very famous pickup for another guitar company and did an excellent job of it.
Tactically put it.
And He also obviously designs the Shawbucker that goes into a lot of modern Fenders, including the new
professional series.
Thank you for digging me out of that hole.
So that's a really cool colour. I just love that sunburst. It's so rich. For that, again, for the price. Cool. And we've done also on the hardtail version, we've done a black. Again, this wonderful V stoptail that we do, which is unique to us, and I think it looks really cool. And in the black, it's just kind of it's a beast of a guitar. That.
And these are kind of semi-comedy prices, aren't they?
Yeah, semi-comedy, yeah. I mean, they're $395 with Bixby, $350 without. Why not? Just get one. And we've got the Torino Green on the junior model now. With stop tail. I should point out these are all really lightweight guitars because they do have a center block, but it's chambered.
Okay.
And I forgot to say on the Electromatics earlier, the new Electromatics have chambered center blocks now, and they didn't have previously. This is obviously the classic Gretsch hollow body shape. We've got the non Bixby version in the black, and we've got the Bixby one with the classic walnut stain. So, anyone who can't quite get up to a Tennessee Rose, that's your answer.
There you go.
And finally, the Junior with Bixby in the gold dust metallic finish.
That's very cool. There's your Malcolm Young on a budget.
So yeah, that's the Streamliners, man.
Fantastic. Well, there we go. Gretsch 2017. Exciting upgrades right across the range.
Yeah.
And all available soon-ish. You said something was available now.
Yeah, everything, Electromatic, Streamliners, and the acoustic guitars, all available from now-ish. And then the professional series models within the next couple of months.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Adam. I think it's time for a beer.
Cheers, indeed.